Öncelikle kendimi tanıtayım. İsmim Emir Diril. Ben Hexagon Studio'da 2012 yılı itibariyle model ve imalat, model ve prototip imalat mühendisi olarak çalışmaktayım. Sizlere bugün anlatacak olduğumuz teknikteki SMP model ve imalat tekniği de ismini Seamless Modeling Paste dediğimiz malzemeden alıyor. Bu malzemenin en büyük avantajı uygulama kolaylığı ve diğer tekniklerle kıyaslandığında doğrudan doğruya üretilecek olan ürünün datasından yola çıkılarak imalata başlandığı için ürünle ilgili nihai
So we are going to talk about the seamless modeling paste material and manufacturing technique and the producing mold for the produced mold. We have a model that we are producing with an epoxy-based model, and I'm going to talk about a boat. In this technique, in the first step of the manufacturing, with the data that we receive, we are making a first of all study on that model. According to the mold or the model, according to the molding and modeling, we are geometrically taking a look how to actually bind the beams and bind the radiuses, what kind of additions should be made, or what kind of particles are going to be used. Is it going to be used one single model, or is it going? Do we need another model as well? And that we are going to decide it, and according to that decision, by adding flashes, we prepare the surface of the model. So after actually preparing this model, in order to actually manufacture the model itself, we are making a threefold of study as well. Our study, first of all, needs to have a steel construction that it is actually having the load on, and the main material so that it actually can hold the material. It has to be made on steel, and besides, the strafor is loaded here, and the bases that are going to hold the strafor, a control plaque material has to be prepared, and we are making a preparation and design for this. The steel construction, it is done accordingly to, of course, a certain calculation so that all the loads are distributed in a balanced way. And on the other hand, the model, a strafor is also been loaded. We are making a planning for the loading of the strafor, and so that the material that are going to be operated is put into the strafor, and the construction is also been put accordingly to the balance load. And later on, by giving the manufacturer, we are prepared the technical drawings. And after the technical drawings are prepared, it is shared together with the manufacturer, and we start the manufacturing. What's important here is that it is a simultaneous manufacturing. On one hand, we are making the construction, and together with the control plaques and also the strafors are also been cut according to the calculated size.
Kesilecek olan kontrol plak ve straforların ebatları gelecek olan normal boyutlarına göre, yani standart tabaka ve
according to its normal dimensions, it's prepared according to the standard dimensions so that the edges don't actually correlate to the wrong places and problems do not arise in the future in terms of loading. We place the contour plaques, and according to the volumes that have been designated before, we put the foams. And after we do the loading, both we use adhesives, which is suitable for both these different materials. After this, process is finished,
bu konstrüksiyon devam ederken bir
while the construction is continuing,
hacmin işlenmesi için gerekli olan CNC programlar hazırlanıyor.
There are the CNC programs.
CNC programları hazır olan strafor hacmimizin işlemesi tezgahımızda başlanıyor.
We start to prepare these on the counters. The important detail at this point is while we actually process the volume, the final data, it has to be 15 millimeters inside, more inside.
And
the process is actually more directed at emptying the inside. And one of the features of this is if there is a need for revision for design, if there needs to be any, if anything needs to be added or emptied, then it's much easier to realize these revisions because this is a phase that we are able to intervene without with many less problems. After we complete this process, before we actually move on to the SMP phase, there has to be a coating. And for coating, we use glass fiber, and this is impregnated with resin. And we put it on the stratfor. It's important, of course, as I stated in the beginning, the geometries, the edges, especially the outer edges and the specifics all have to be taken into consideration. And after the lamination is completed, there is a curing. And after the curing, the SMP margin for SMP margin applications, there is one more application that needs to be completed. And this is the SMP material which is going to be applied so that it will hold the surface, the lamination which has been cured.
Bu zımparalama işleminin getirdiği iki tane fayda var. Birincisi, kurumuş olan lamine malzemenin
process or this phase
parlaklığını gidermek
ve allows us to make sure that the shining of the resin is actually gotten rid of.
Ve bu şekilde macun uygulamaya hazır bir yüzey
then the paste is ready to be
implemented. Görmüş olduğunuz gibi
as you can see the surface with our epoxy dispenser machine there's a two component epoxy machine which is being used and with this after the sandpaper process is actually completed we move on to the SMP paste coating.
We
it's a thickness of 25 millimeters, but as you know, the fiber surface is about 15, minus 15 millimeters. It's been processed with minus 15 millimeters of offset and a thickness of 1 to 1.5 millimeters thickness of the fiber surface or the fiber layer and the heat that may emanate this heat actually does carry the risk of completely sometimes destroying the stratfor. So all the surface, we make sure that there is a thickness of 25 millimeters of this material. You can see the carina here, and it's been used with SMP paste. It's been coated rather with SMP paste. This is usually 24 hours, but it will change according to the climate conditions, according to the weather conditions, and if the weather is warmer, it can take less. If it's colder, it will take longer than the 24 hours. And usually, but the standard is 24 hours for the curing period. And the SMP surface, regarding the SMP surface, there are different programs which are being prepared. And the SMP coated model, then we start the process phase. The first, the difference between the first process and this is a 0 millimeter of the offset on the CNC counter. And together with this processing, in our end product, we begin to see our end product, because after the first processing, we actually take into consideration to the surface quality, which was not the case in the first processing. We look at the more detailed areas, for example, the gaps, the water canals, etc. So the details are very much taken into consideration in the second processing. After the processing, let's say minimum of 10 millimeters of thickness, a paste which is which has a minimum 10 millimeters of thickness. So that is on top of the strat 4 material. And after the processing, we have the coating. Of course, no matter how fine you actually operate on this, and we don't want these to be seen on the end surface, there is first a process of sandpaper. And then, in connection with the project, there is an undercoating and different kinds of polyester undercoatings are used. It could be epoxy-based, it could be other kinds of bases. It depends on what the customer wants. And at the next stage, which is the painting, that's the shining and the last paint, the coat paint. So the surface is prepared for that last phase. And this last layer of paint is when the product, the quality of the product will become, will show itself. And if there is a mold that is going to be produced from this product, this will be the phase that will show all of these specifics. And the paint which is used here and the shiny, and how shiny it is, whether the paint that is used enables the surface to be shiny or not. And as was the case in the first undercoating, and again according to the demands of the customer and according to the project itself, there will be alterations, but we can see the end product, we can see the shape, we can see its form, and with this shining, of course, this is a very high quality surface. And at the end of this, we can see the end products. This is a model, and this is the FRP, the fiber reinforced plastic mold, which has actually been shaped shaped from this model. And as you can see in the product, all the details on the model are present, they can be seen, the rigidness of the material, and because it has been CNC processed and because final data has been used, it is quite within the boundaries of tolerance. It is in correlation with the quality that is desired. Again, the SMP material which is being used, and that's another advantage because it has a very long and durable life cycle, the amount of molds that can be produced, it can be reached as many as you like. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them.
soru yok
herhalde. Any questions?
Tabii. Şöyle söyleyeyim. Burada
I'm sorry, there was no use of the microphone. I don't know what the question was.
Alırken,
when the mold was
yani
taken,
kalıp üretiyorsak tabii ki
if we're going to produce a mold,
ama model üretilirken,
that's what we take into consideration naturally, but if we're going to produce a model,
firma tarafından uygulanan bir şey. Tabii firma bizden bunun için ayrıca kendisi tekrar maça talep ederse onun da.
That's what we take into consideration, but sometimes the company itself asks us to take a mold from the model. Is there an infusion method? I think one of the participants asked.
Yani kalıp yapacak olursak yine
if you're going to produce a mold, again we use the SMP technique.
Mesela şimdi bizim burada ürettiğimiz modelden üretilen kalıbı biz üretmiyoruz.
The mold that we have produced from this model,
biz,
no, we do not produce the mold.
Göre, eğer kalıp üretilecekse,
if there is going to be a mold which is going to be produced, then we make sure that that mold is produced according to SMP technique. So you bring it from point zero to the mold, producing mold stage. If you want a mold from us, I'm talking about this manufacturing technique, obviously, we are able to produce a mold for you, yes, and together with the core, which is required by the mold, that will all be taken into consideration. There are wings, for example, helizoid wings. I'm sorry, I can't hear the participant's question.
The
product or the mold that is going to be produced, according to the geometry, of course, it can be one part, it can be multi-parts. It will all change according to the geometry that needs to be used.
Epoxy bazlı.
The paste that you use, what is the base of that? Epoxy based.
Evet.
What about the heat or the temperature that you use?
Normal şartlarda uygulamayı.
Now
yani
we
20-25
degrees.
Uygulama sıcaklığından ziyade
rather than the
olan
temperature of the application, the important issue is the curing temperature. Because as I said, according to the weather conditions, sometimes, of course, if it's the winter, the curing process takes a bit longer. If it's summer, it will be 20-22 hours. In the meanwhile, I wanted to say something regarding
seamless modeling paste.
It is, as the word itself entails, there are no seams. It's very modern. But the material, of course, because it is, it bonds with each other very homogeneously. And when you look at the material very closely, you don't see any fastened, any line which is a result of these bonded or fastened places. You don't see any of those. The dispenser machine we use actually arranges the mix. Because the machine itself actually deals with the mixture.
Tezgahımızın boyu 26 metre.
The bench is about 26 meters.
Biz burada bu tezgahta
and
zaten
26 meters and it's 3 to 4 meters.
Bir karinayı tek seferde işleyebiliyoruz.
We are able to process one karin at one time because the wings come from the United States as far as I know. So maybe it can
tabii
be
ki.
Dealt with as two different parts.
Bizim tezgahımız şu anda Türkiye'deki en büyük model işleme tezgahı.
Our bench is the largest one in Turkey right now. And of course, because of the geometry, it will be possible to do it in two parts. When the participants do not use a microphone, I'm not able to hear the questions. Sorry.
Hı Yo, tabii ki o geometrilerin hepsi zaten önce bilgisayar
of course the geometry
sonra,
all the geometry
yani
is actually firstly created in a computer environment and then they are put into practice.
Başka soru?
Any other questions? What about the cost? There are two main items. One is the workmanship, and secondly, it's the material. And the skills, the workmanship skills, change according to the customer's desires, the customer's demand or customer's wishes, rather. And sometimes, for example, the paste, the thickness of the paste could be decreased from 25 millimeters to 10 millimeters. It will depend, actually.
Tabii ki siz işçilikle o açığı kapatmaya çalışıyorsunuz. Yüzey kalitesindeki ve geometrideki işte dediğim gibi buradaki en büyük avantaj
the main advantage in this technique is
model üzerine uyguladığınız için
it is a process which is already designed on the computer and you just actually implement what has been designed in the computer or what has been arranged in a computerized environment. Epoxy is a resin, yes. And we use an epoxy-based resin.
Elyafı zaten
the fiber we implemented, we apply it with an epoxy-based resin so that problems don't arise.
Zaten burada görüyorsunuz.
You can see it from these photos. It is an application which actually leaves gaps in between. But there is a heat which emanates from this application. And the heat, the maximum, when you apply it simultaneously, it is a maximum temperature, the heat, and it can cause cracks, it can cause different sorts of problems. So the idea is that the styrofoam is the least affected from this application.
Yani tabii ki bu uygulamayı yapıyoruz.
Of course, after this application, there's a curing, and after this has been cured, then we move on to the application.
Boşluk olabilir derken.
So there are two different phases. One is after the curing process, the layer is cold, and then the second part is applied. So without any gaps, so next to the solid layer, when you start the curing process, I feel as though there can be a gap, and that will actually mean a decrease or a reduction in the strength of the material. I would like to tell you, before all else, that this material is very, very strong, whether it's cured or not. And secondly, while we are making these implementations, while you talked about a gap appearing, but the dispenser that we use and the way it is actually applied in terms of the width of the material also, there is actually no room for gaps. That's how it is applied. Because of this application, there can be no room for gaps. Maybe I don't know the process very well, but I have not been satisfied exactly with your answer. But all of this design, I'm sure all of these fine details have been taken into consideration, but chemistry has its own nature, and no matter how homogeneously you spread it out, there is going to be a phase difference between the two layers. There must be some kind of gap because of this situation. And as a result of this, maybe because of your process conditions, logically, maybe because the heat that emanates will cause a problem in your manufacturing, but I think maybe that heat actually means that there is less problem in terms of strength. Maybe need to see it at the production plant. I would like to give you information about another detail, perhaps, that might satisfy you. 24 hours, I told you, is the curing period of the SMP paste. And when it's 24 hours, the heat that emanates to make sure that it reaches a level which will not damage the styrofoam, there is quite a long time, actually. And because we make sure that the application is realized within that long period, you do not have, like, one part is very solid and the other part is much less solid, which will cause a problem. If the geometry that we want, if it's larger or if there is a need for a larger volume styrofoam, then we are able to connect everything that we have in our hand. Again, the adhesive used is a material that's not going to damage the styrofoam in any way. For the transportation of this product, we organize very special vehicles. And as I said, when the construction is taking place, the material is going to be, the design actually takes this into consideration so that the material is processed as little as possible. And both in terms of the transportation and both how the vehicle is used, the transportation is always realized according to the need of the material. The material is always taken into consideration. The material, that's a nominal thickness, but 25 millimeters, there will be no actually liquid flow if the thickness is 25 millimeters. That's one of the most beautiful parts of this material. It's homogeneous. You can actually apply it on any kind of surface you want, and you don't have any kinds of air balloons or any kind of problems that you usually encounter during these processes. Because here they wanted, in the photographs that I showed you, because they wanted a model, we produced a model. But if you want a mold, we can follow the same processes and actually produce a mold for you. As far as I know, 90 to 80 degrees. That's the resistance temperature of this material, as far as I know. Any other questions? When the participants don't use a microphone, we are not able to hear the questions. I would like to remind you. Of course, it has a certain life cycle. It has a certain shelf life.
Uh, Bununla yapılan kalıptan toplam kaç
the mold that is produced from this, how many parts will we be able to produce? 20-25 products from this mold. So there's one mold that has been produced. If it's 25 millimeters thickness, wall thickness, yes.
Başka soru? Bu kadar galiba. Teşekkür ederim dinlediğiniz için.
Thank you very much for listening.